Brighton CCA present The Exile of Dionysus, the first major exhibition of works in a UK institution by American artist Bill Lynch, free from the 6th of August until the 15th of October. I spoke with Ben Roberts, the artistic director of the Centre of Contemporary Arts, to understand why he decided to put up this exhibition.
This whole show is The Exile of Dionysus, and it's by an American painter called Bill Lynch, who was basically painting in the sort of latter part of the, I guess, the sort of 1970s, 1980s and 1990s. He died in 2013. And this is his first institutional show in the UK ever. So it's a real coup for the Brighton CCA and for the university to have this work here for people to see for the first time.
So what inspired you to put an exhibition of Ben Lynch?
Well, two things really. I mean, I first came across his work in Berlin about 7-8 years ago in a gallery there. I knew nothing about the work at that stage. I just happened to go into this place and was absolutely blown away by it. It was quite a big show of works at that stage, and some of the things that I really love about it are his confidence with drawing and as a draftsman, but also his use of colour and the way that those two sort of things interact. So you get, I mean, this is obviously a fabulous example. There's a real delicacy in the sort of birds and the sort of the detail and the rendering of things, but also a sort of a real beautiful sense of space, I think, partly comes from his interest in sort of 13th century Chinese painting that you see, you know, where there are the mists in the mountains, and it's as much about what's left out as what you can actually see, and your mind fills in the gaps in some ways. And I think Bill's work and his approach to painting has a lot of that power and a lot of that sort of formal quality. But I think he's also referencing a lot of different histories, a lot of mythologies. He was very interested in popular culture, but also in anthropology and in history and all sorts of, sort of different areas of interest, like geology and so on. So I think a lot of that comes through, and I think they end up being paintings or a body of work of real power and beauty.
And also the material he's been painting on, it's quite, you say it's just been done because it was cheap.
But yeah, I mean, essentially, I mean, he went to college in New York and then sort of stayed around there, and there was a real burgeoning commercial gallery scene at that time, but he never really showed work. He very rarely sold work whilst he was alive, if ever. And so he wasn't like a rich man at all. So The boards and the things that you see the paintings on, I think, are really a contingent thing. You know, it's just what he found on the street or what was lying around and that he could just sort of use. But I think one of the real powers of the work is that he incorporates those materials into the images that he's making. So the knots and the grains of the wood become part of the images that he's making. He's really sort of utilizing the natural qualities of the boards in that way. So they almost become a sort of sculptural sort of part of the work. And I think that's something else that is really powerful in it, is he's not afraid of the imperfections and the things around the edges. He embraces it all. The exhibition is on until the 15th of October, and it's free to come and see. We have a reading room and various sort of texts and things in the reading room about his influences. There's a new text that we've commissioned from Vanessa Onwemzi, who has written it but has also recorded it, so she's reading it, so you can hear that and you can download it on our website as well. So yeah, it's on through the summer, so people can stop by and visit time and again.